Hello everyone, my name is Prashant Agrawal and I'm working as an Analytics Specialist Solution Architect in AWS, where I primarily focus on Amazon OpenSearch Service. And today I will be talking about managing time series data with data streams. So before getting into the data stream, let me explain about Amazon OpenSearch Service. So Amazon OpenSearch Service is a managed service that makes it easy to deploy, operate, and scale OpenSearch along with legacy Elasticsearch cluster in AWS Cloud. So let's take a quick detour and talk about what is OpenSearch. So OpenSearch is a community-driven open source search and analytics suite, which is derived from the Apache 2.0 licensed version of Elasticsearch 7.10.2 and Kibana 7.10.2. One of the common use cases with OpenSearch is to index continually generating time series data such as logs, metrics, and traces. And previously, automating index rollover meant that you had to first create a write index, configure a rollover alias, and then verify those indexes are being rolled over as expected or not. So which makes the bootstrapping step to be more cumbersome than it needs to be. But with the help of data stream, it is optimized for time series dataset that is primarily append-only in nature and simplify all the initial setup processing for the data. So let's look like what are the challenges with the time series indices. So this particular diagram talks about how users set up their indexes for time series data. So they start with setting up the index template where they define index mapping and alias, which would be helpful for querying the data. Next, they have the index state management policy to set up the index rotation and then writing the rollover policies and the write alias for defining those indices. So now let's look at like how data stream works at very high level and solve some of these problems which we discussed, being the first class citizen as to store the time series data. So data stream has one or more auto-generated backing indices and prefixed by .ds and then data stream name and the generation ID. So you can see here those names are like .ds-logs-nginx-00001-02 and 03. So then for any write operation, you send the request to data stream. It will send it to the latest index. Once an index is rolled, it will become read-only and you cannot add any new document to the rotated index. So typically in log analytics scenario, there is rarely a modification. And if needed, you can run update by query or delete by query in order to back up those older indices or delete the data from those indices. Now talking about the search request. So while running the search query, data stream route those requests to all backing indices. And of course, you can filter out the data by the timestamp to intelligently search those data sets. So here, whenever you send any search request, you send it to the data stream name, and then it will route all of your queries to like .ds-logs-nginx-00001-02 and 03. So in a nutshell, data stream helps you to intelligently manage the time series data where developer or operation team can perform focus on the development and growing their business rather than spending time on the management tasks such as managing those indices or the different data sets. So this concludes a quick overview of data stream. If you would like to know more about data stream or looking for a demo, please check out our getting started page over here and a link of demo as well, which talks in depth about the data stream. So thank you for listening and feel free to reach out to us if you have any further questions. Thank you.